My name is Katie Lay, and I'd like to welcome you tonight to this evening's performance of the Wesley Bellringers. This evening, I'm going to spend a little bit of time telling you about the history of our program, our instruments, the music that we play, the ringers themselves. But if you come up with a question that I haven't addressed, please hold on to it. There will be time later in the program for a question and answer period. For now, I invite you all to take a big, deep breath, and I'd like to thank you for taking an hour or so out of your busy Christmas season. I know there are a lot of things that you could be doing tonight, and we are really grateful to have such a lovely, big audience to share our music with this evening. This next piece in our program is an arrangement of a French carol called Masters in This Hall. We hope that you enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Our choir was founded in 1963 by a man named Ed Duncan, who was then serving as the youth director of Christ United Methodist Church. And he felt that his teenagers didn't have enough stuff to do, so he managed to convince 9 ringers to sell hoagie sandwiches in order to raise enough money to buy their first set of 25 English handbells. Since they played their first Christmas concert, or their first concert on Christmas Eve of 1963, the choir has been in continuous operation, and over 500 teenagers have participated in the choir, something we're very proud of. Membership is open to members and non-members of Christ United Methodist Church. Musical background, musical experience is not required. We are a non-auditioned choir, another thing that we're very proud of. And all you have to do is commit to our rigorous schedule and promise you'll show up. We'll take anybody. This next piece in your program was our feature piece with the Kensington Symphony Orchestra. We played with them on Friday night, and we arranged this piece, the conductor of that orchestra arranged this piece with a full string section to accompany it, and it was lovely. We're playing it for you again tonight. It's missed a little bit of that depth without the string section, but it's still a wonderful piece. It's an arrangement of Lo, How a Rose Air Blooming. We hope that you enjoy. Thank you. Thank you very much. The next piece in your program is going to be directed by our assistant director, Tony Slinger, and I'm going to give you a little bit of background about him and a little bit more background about the handbell ministry at Christ United Methodist Church. So our choir was founded in 1963, and after several years of so many teenagers going through and having fun and going on tours and playing so many concerts, several adults in our congregation went, well, I want to play bells too. So they started an adult bell choir called Appraisiation, and that's been ringing for many, many years. I actually don't, shame on me, I should know when they were founded, but they've been ringing for many, many years. And after that, we decided, well, we ought to have a program for younger ringers. So we started a 7th and 8th grade bell choir for that age group called the Asbury Bell Ringers, which is what our assistant Tony now directs. And then after that, we thought, well, maybe we should add a chime choir for even younger kids. So now we have a 4th, 5th, and 6th grade chime choir as well. So there's bells for all ages at Christ United, something we're very proud of. As I mentioned, this next piece in your program will be directed by Tony Slinger. While the ringers kind of put themselves back together, I'm going to take a moment to introduce the next song that we'll be playing. It's actually not printed in your program. Snuck it in there. But in the early days of bell choirs and handbell ringing, especially when our choir was founded, handbell music, music arranged specifically for bells, was very scarce. A lot of choirs would just ring straight out of the hymnal, or they would arrange pieces themselves to be performed. So our founding director had to arrange a ton of music for us. And the next piece that we're going to play is an arrangement that he did of God Rest You Merry Gentlemen. It's been adapted for the number of ringers that we have this year. And it's really special to us to be able to play a little bit of our history and to share that with you tonight. So we hope that you enjoy. Thank you very much. I'd like to take a moment now to tell you about the instruments that we use. We ring a 5.5-octave set of Malmark English handbells. That's the bronze bell that you've heard most this evening. They range in size from the G2, which looks and sounds like this, and weighs 20 pounds at the beginning of the concert, to the A8, which looks and sounds like this. It's basically just a shot glass on a handle back there. We also ring a 5-octave set of Malmark hand chimes. That's the silver and black instrument that you heard during the last piece. The largest of these is also the G2, which looks and sounds like this. And it's basically just a metal 2x4 back there. We also ring a 2-octave set of Schulmerich silver melody bells. You heard these in the first piece. It's the silver cylindrical bell. It sounds like this. It has that nice, bright, crisp tone. We like to use it to bring out melody lines where we can. We also ring a 2-octave set of Whitechapel cup bells, and they look and sound like this. They also have a distinct sound, but we like to use it in a way of accentuating melody lines and notes that are a little more gentle, a little softer there. We also have a set of tuned cowbells, which you heard featured earlier in the program. We're pretty proud of those. In the back, we have our percussion station. They have a variety of instruments back there. You've heard several of them tonight, and you'll hear some more that you haven't yet. They have a glockenspiel, wind chimes. They've got orchestra chimes back there. And on Augs's left is a set of Pettit and Fritzen handbells from Holland, and they sound like this. I call them handbells because they indeed used to have handles and clapper mechanisms like our Malmarks do, but they no longer manufacture that bell or parts for that bell. So over the years, as that set of bells broke and broke and broke and we ran out of repair parts, we decided to strip them down and hang them from a carillon rather than lose their unique sound. In front of Augs is an instrument that we believe is unique to the Wesley bell ringers called the boomagong, and it sounds like this. A gentleman heard the choir play in the very early years before anyone was manufacturing the big bass bells that you see on the back row. He wanted to give the choir a deeper, fuller sound. He also hoped to mass market that instrument to bell choirs everywhere. Unfortunately for the bell ringing world, it didn't work out that way, but luckily for us, we got a boomagong out of it. The next piece in your program is an arrangement of In the Bleak Midwinter.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. The Ringers rehearse their music through the school year, September through June. We prepare for our Christmas season by attending a fall rehearsal retreat where we take all our equipment up to Camp Pine Cliff and we rehearse for the weekend. They also get to eat and sleep and play games, I promise. It's not all work. But that's where we do the bulk of our preparation for our Christmas program. And then in the spring, we'll start with fresh music on January 1st. We might keep a couple Christmas pieces. And then we'll start with a new batch of music and rehearse to prepare for our summer tour. Our summer tour consists of 2 weeks to a different area of the United States and sometimes into Canada when we can get there. And the Ringers will perform typically about 14 concerts in 16 days. So it's a whirlwind adventure, but we get to see a lot of really cool stuff along the way. The Ringers also work year-round raising money in order to afford our equipment, new uniforms, supplies, anything you can imagine, and also to support our summer tour. It takes a lot. We have to rent a 56-passenger bus to take all of us and all of our equipment across the country, so it gets to be a lot of work. We raise money by selling, like I mentioned, those hoagie sandwiches earlier. That lasted a very long time. We switched to Super Bowl food. We switched to a Valentine's Day dinner dance. We've sold wrapping paper for I don't know how long. And our biggest fundraiser is a rummage sale. So all year long, we collect gently used unwanted items from our congregation and the surrounding community. And we pack it all downstairs in the church basement. And then twice a year, we haul it all up, set it all out, and sell it, usually back to the people who gave us stuff in the first place. So it's a pretty good cycle we've got going on. Another way that we support ourselves is by soliciting a free will offering at our concerts, which is what this talking point has been building up to. I emphasize free will in the free will offering. We're busy up here. We're not paying attention. There are no cameras. But if you feel so inclined to support us in our music ministry, we will have some ringers and chaperones passing the plate during this next piece, and we would greatly appreciate your kindness.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now would be the time for that question and answer period that I mentioned earlier in the program. Are there any questions that I can answer about the ringers, the music, the equipment, anything at all? Yes. Ooh, favorite songs? Pretty good mix. I heard Sleigh Ride, Aloha Rose, God With Us, and Masters. No? Okay. That's a tough question. Differing opinions. Oh, Tony's upset. Carolers Hoedown. Carolers Hoedown. That's a good question, though. I don't think anybody's ever asked that. Any other questions? That means I've done my job really well, so that's a good thing. If you come up with any questions after the show, don't hesitate to approach myself, Tony, the ringers, or any of our chaperones. We all really love to talk about this, so if there's anything that you're curious about and didn't want to ask, don't hesitate. We'd love to tell you. I would like to close our program by just, again, thanking you for taking time out of your busy schedules to be here with us. It's not much use being in a bell choir without an audience to share your music with, so we're really grateful for you being here with us this evening. We hope that this has been a little bit of a break for you and that it's hopefully rejuvenating and getting you into the holiday spirit. And we would like to wish you all a very safe and Merry Christmas.